Hi, my name is Judith Verstegen, and I lead the GeoSimulation Modeling Lab at the Institute for Geoinformatics. In this presentation, I will shortly introduce my research and teaching that is related to geosimulation modeling. We are currently facing global change, which leads to several issues. In this figure, you see some examples of that. For example, irrigation can lead to water shortage. Agricultural expansion can lead to soil pollution. The increased impermeability of the soil because of buildings and roads can lead to a higher amount of surface runoff and thereby an increased frequency of flooding. Then deforestation causes, among other things, carbon emissions, which increases the greenhouse effect. Urban expansion may lead to habitat fragmentation and then loss of biodiversity. And also an increase in fallow land caused by land abandonment or mining can cause erosion. Now, how is all of this related to geosimulation? Well, all these problems have one thing in common, that is that there is a certain system and the state of this system changes over time. And these changes, they have certain impacts, namely these issues mentioned here. Let's look at an example of a geosimulation model. And that's a model of urban expansion. Here you see the city of Madrid and how it was in 1990. We have then implemented a model of urban expansion to project, even though it is here the past that we're looking at, to project how Madrid will grow over time. You see here in black the urban area and in white the non-urban area. In between, you see red colors, and red colors indicate that there is a certain probability that the location changes from non-urban to urban. The fact that it's a probability also implies that there is some uncertainty. That is very often the case when we do geosimulation modeling. We never know all the rules of the system exactly, so there's always some uncertainty involved. But we can definitely see here some locations that are more likely to be transformed to urban areas based on the rules that we have identified in the system. Now, as an additional analysis, we could now look at the impacts that would be caused by this change from non-urban to urban. So now you saw one example, but let's give a more precise definition of what a geosimulation model is. It is some kind of simplified representation of a system that is implemented as a computer model. In the courses that I teach at the Institute for Geoinformatics, you will learn how to build such a model. And you will also learn what we can use such models for. Typically, the research question that we answer with geosimulation models can be divided into two categories. The first category is questions for understanding. So, how does this system work, for example? It may seem contradictory, because we need to know the rules of the system before we can implement them. But this implementation is typically an iterative process. So we have a certain hypothesis how the system works. We build a computational model out of that. Then that model gives us system state changes that are supposed to occur. Then we can compare that with what we observe in the real world and thereby increase our knowledge of the workings of this system. The second category of questions are the what-if questions. That is, for example, what would happen to urban expansion if we implement a new highway in Madrid? That highway could namely attract more expansion because it shortens travel time to certain destinations. Another example would be, what happens if we implement a national park close to Madrid because a national park would mean that no urban expansion can take place there anymore. So as a result, the urban expansion will take place somewhere else, and the geosimulation model would tell you where that would be likely to happen. Now, why do we use actually geosimulation models? Why can't we just do our experiment in the real world? Because we do have these systems in the real world, so we could just do collect data ourselves, you might think. Well, in most cases, the systems that we're interested in are simply too large to do field work. To look at even the whole city of Madrid would already be large, but some models contain a whole country, for example, land use changes in a country, or even the whole world. So it's just impossible to do empirical research for the whole extent of your study area then. Secondly, response times of these systems are typically very large. So if we would want to know what is the effect of a new highway in Madrid, we would first have to build the highway. That can take already several years. And then we would have to take some years to see the effects of building houses. So altogether, it takes many years, whereas with a geosimulation model, we could see the effect in the course of seconds. Then furthermore, with a geosimulation model, we can evaluate multiple scenarios. I already gave the example of the highway in the national park. We could, for example, test several places for the national park or for the highway. And in the real world system, you can test only one option, because there is only one world. Finally, in the real world, we can't really afford mistakes. So in the picture with the tiger, you see what may happen. If we install the national park in the wrong place, then we may still have a large decrease of biodiversity, leaving us with only one tiger, just as an example. So I hope that this has helped you to better understand what geosimulation is, and perhaps also that it has aroused your interest in geoinformatics. Thanks for watching. Bye.